Let's face it, labor and delivery is usually described as the most painful event you'll ever experience in your entire life if you're carrying a baby. Now that can come from your friends, movies, I mean we see it all the time, new moms in a movie screaming at the top of her lungs, or maybe you watch some birthing videos right here on YouTube and somebody was literally screaming and in so much excruciating pain that you were just like, oh gosh, how am I gonna do that? It's too painful. But let me tell you, I delivered my fourth child just a few months ago and it wasn't painful to me. I did not have an epidural and that's because I was in the car. I delivered her in my car. And one of the things that really helped me to manage that pain and have this easy birthing experience, even though I was in the middle of the street, was an essential oil. So this video is all about five essential oils that you will learn how to incorporate those essential oils into your birthing and labor delivery experience so that you can not only reduce pain but also increase the strength of the contractions, shorten the labor. I mean, there are so many benefits with some of these essential oils, so definitely keep watching the video and learn all about it. If you are new here, hi, my name is Brittany Kelly. Welcome to my YouTube family. Here we're very supportive of one another. We talk about pregnancy, postpartum, parenting, early education, I have family vlogs, and I'm just sharing that super mom life journey. So if you're into that and you're a supportive person, go ahead and subscribe to this channel. Hit the notification bell. And make sure to like this video so that I know you care. And for all of my returning family members, so glad to see you again. Also hit that like button and let's get into these magical essential oils. So back in the day, before childbirthing got taken over by the medical community, midwives used to use the power of plant medicine, such as essential oils, to help women and assist them through childbirth. And that's something along the lines of starting labor as well as managing pain. If you want some proof of the power of plant medicine, just take a look at my midwife's brew video. I have it right here on YouTube. I made this video all about the brew where I induced my labor, literally started labor within hours. And it's four ingredients and it's all plant-based. So very powerful stuff. But in my original recipe, I changed how the old recipe had an essential oil, because essential oils are very, very powerful. They're very powerful. So I decided for my recipe to be a little smoother and still be very effective. But in this video, we're gonna talk about how we can use essential oils by smelling them, not ingesting them. In fact, please, with any of the essential oils or any of the advice that is given in this video, it is from personal experience and personal research, but make sure you do your own, and definitely this is not to be taken as medical advice. You have to make these decisions on your own with your medical provider. So with that said, take a listen to all of these amazing essential oils that actually are going to help reduce pain. I mean, I can't even believe how much this one essential oil really helped my labor and delivery. This is worth hearing. So before we get into the list, let's just talk about how you can use these essential oils. Of course, you can always add them to a diffuser. You could put a little bit of water and a few drops, anywhere between 2-3, depending on your diffuser, maybe 20. Just make sure you take a look at the instructions on the essential oil that you're using or the diffuser that you're using to know exactly how much. And you can let that aroma be all in the air and just fill you up with its power just by smell. You could actually take some water, add a few drops, maybe 2-3, 4, 5 drops, put a washcloth inside of the water, wring it out, take that washcloth, place it on the top of your face, on your forehead, or the back of your neck, your shoulders, your lower back. You can place them in these places and actually have it really relieve some of the tension and stress from labor. Also, some of the essential oils can be applied topically, but not all. So definitely check out the instructions on each, but you can add them to your wrist or the back of your ear or to your temple to get that aroma going. You also can just paste a couple drops onto a piece of tissue and smell that piece of tissue to also help you. For me, I was in the car when I was smelling my essential oil, so I literally smelled it a few times straight from the bottle and set it down and took on my contractions. It not only helped with the pain, but it also helped speed up my labor. You also can make a little room spray. Just take some water and a couple of drops of essential oil in a spray bottle and spray it around the room where you are going to be birthing, whether that's at home or even in the hospital. So what magical essential oil helped me while I was in labor? So that's going to be my first one that I'm going to talk about. It is lavender essential oil. Super popular. A lot of people know about this one. So I actually was smelling this lavender oil right in the car. Lavender essential oil not only calms you while you're in labor, but it also gets you into this super relaxed state that you need to kind of open up and have the baby descend down and out of your body. You also can experience the contractions getting stronger. Lavender essential oil helps the uterine contractions strengthen and to have a stronger contraction. And if the contraction is stronger, it is going to help push your baby down. That means your labor is going to be quicker. That means the pain is going to be shorter. So all of these things lead to a less painful labor and delivery. This is a must have, my number one. Number two is neroli essential oil. Now this essential oil is actually known for its ability to help alleviate anxiety and fear. Now, the number one reason why many, many women that I have spoken to don't want to go natural or epidural free with their delivery is because they're afraid. They're afraid of what's gonna happen. They're afraid of how much pain it's gonna be, and they just don't want to face it. But once you step away from the fear and the anxiety, all of a sudden, you realize you are more than capable of doing this without intervention. You know, sans every, you know, if you're having a normal vaginal delivery, right? You can do it on your own. You absolutely don't have to have an epidural if you don't want to. So having some neroli oil, especially if you're having any fears about your birth, whether it's medicated or unmedicated, will really help you calm down and have a peaceful delivery. Also, if you are too nervous, too afraid, your body actually can stall labor. It can go into the fight or flight and actually turn your labor off and stall it, just in case you need to actually run. It's this biological response for women to protect yourself if you were in nature, right? You're a human being. So you want to make sure that you are not doing anything that's going to stall your labor. You just want it to progress forward so that you can see your baby. So neroli oil is going to help you get there. So if you smell it or use it in diffuser, it's going to really help calm you down. Number three is jasmine essential oil. This is also another oil that, like lavender, will help you not only calm down and reduce the pain, but also it's going to strengthen the contractions. And we want strong, effective contractions. And honestly, I felt like last time I didn't even push. I felt like my contractions were so strong from me drinking raspberry leaf tea to having my lavender essential oil being smelled in the moment. My contractions were super strong and really just pushed the baby out. I really felt like the baby surfed out. I just took an out breath. And the baby came out. And that was the first time. And that was the first time I used lavender essential oil. It's the first time I used an essential oil. So I really think that that had something to do with it. So something that you can actually do is you can alternate between lavender and jasmine, or you can make a little blend in your diffuser, however you want to take that on. But definitely having these two together is going to help your labor experience. All right, now let's talk about myrrh. This essential oil actually helps women with their cervix, right? So a lot of women always ask, hey, how dilated were you when you induced your labor? Because they want to know how far open your cervix was. And this is an important part of the labor process, the cervix dilating open to make the opening for the baby to come out. Well, this essential oil actually helps to encourage the dilation of the cervix. Usually women start pushing somewhere between 9 and 10 centimeters. So with this essential oil, myrrh, helping to get that cervix open, you get closer and closer to the end of your delivery, which means closer to seeing your baby. Now let's talk about clary sage. This essential oil should never, ever, ever be used while you are pregnant. Let me repeat, do not use this essential oil while you are pregnant because it encourages labor to start. Now, when you are ready to deliver your baby, this is the go. You want to grab this essential oil and you want to smell it, or you can, you know, wring it up in the water and put it on the back of your lower back or the back of your neck. This essential oil helps to kick start your labor. I know a lot of women, when they're at the tail end of their pregnancy, they're really looking for ways to induce their labor. And if they aren't as ready as I always am to go ahead and take my midwife's brew, then they can turn to this essential oil and see how smelling it in a diffuser helps their labor to start. So if that's what you're looking for, to start your labor and not only just, you know, manage the pain, but you just want to get it going, this is the essential oil that you will need. All right, so I have a playlist right here that you can watch that has all these other tips and tricks about labor and delivery, as well as my labor and delivery stories. So please take the time to go ahead and watch that, especially if you're a mama who is expecting, and if you have a friend who is expecting, share, because you care. And I will see you in the next video or in the comment section below. Thank you for watching.